let's do this.
How you doing?
All right, can you see
it? Did you go to the parade that was downtown last week? I didn't make it. I was working. Yeah, yeah.
Hi, everyone. Welcome. Welcome. I think that's everyone now. I'm going to email you each a list of online events happening today that shared links and passwords. Join them, and if they let you, talk about rebuilding the police and the Black Lives Matter agenda. Remember, we're not Black, so it's important that everyone sees that this matters to everyone. Oh, except you. Who are you?
I'm a fur.
Welcome. Hit the main talking points. Feel free to make them your own, of course.
Is this like we're cold calling on Zoom?
Yeah, pretty much. Don't let the momentum die, people. We got to keep things going before they escalate again. That's my phone. We'll reconvene in 1 hour. Best of luck. I'll be waiting here.
Let's do this.
Hello?
Policeman's Benefit Association. If we send you an envelope, can we count on you to return it with a contribution?
Are you kidding me? Do you watch the news? Do you have any idea how terrible it is that these bad cops contribute to the current climate of distrust and fear? Do you know how complicated it is these days for people to ask for help if they need it?
Is that a yes or a no?
Do I get a sticker?
So every officer will know you support them.
Send it.
Biliyorum değişik ama zevkli olacak.
O benim doğum günü zaten hiç kutlamaz.
Sevecek ama.
Evet.
Bence de. Hazırlıkları yaptın mı?
Sürpriz olacak. Dur, o kim?
Hello, I'm Fu.
Can I help you?
You can help the whole country.
O disc jockey olmalı.
Disc jockey?
Shh, wait. Who are you?
I'm just an ordinary citizen like yourselves. And I'm here to urge you all to join Americans all across the country to demand that the government rebuild the police as a public safety agency. Do you think that the police have failed to serve citizens in this country?
I guess.
And do you think that they've been especially unfair to working class communities of color?
Probably.
Then I urge you all to join our organization. We're organizing a drive-by demonstration at the city council where the police budget will be in the meeting. Can we count on you all to join us next Monday between 4 and 4:30 p.m.?
No, not really, no.
Oh. And should I assume that since no one else is talking, that no one else is interested?
You can assume that they don't speak English. And we speak Turkish, and we're planning a birthday event for our grandma here in Turkey.
Oh, disc jockey değilmiş.
Tabii ki değil.
Obero's tatlı.
Susun.
Like the country Turkey.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't notice that. Now I see the flag, but you can still make a difference if you send an email. I can paste you guidelines and any email addresses.
Sure.
They're in the chat, so you can share them with your family and everyone else. And happy birthday, Nana.
Benim annem doğum günümde diz çok dahi getirmedi.
Turkey?
Tengo que ir con mis amigos, así que allí me platican.
Amigos? Buenos para nada será.
¿Aún usted me vas a decir con quién juntarme?
Vas por el mal camino. Todo lo que hacen es estarse pachequeando.
Cut. Remember your island. Hey, you. Yes, you. Are you one of the extras? Turn off your video.
Yeah.
Your mic's off. And we have work to do, so bye-bye. Okay, from the top. And recording, action.
Se lo ha ganado a pulso.
0 for 2.
Whose idea was this?
So again, anybody has an idea of something happening where we could really make a difference and we... Oh, well, hello. Welcome, friend. Thank you for joining us. Let's give Fu a welcome. Yes. Yeah.
Hi, thank you. Thank you.
Fu, is that short for something?
Sort of. My full name is Fuqi. Fuqi is a traditional Hmong name. I'm Hmong American.
Well, I speak for all of us when I say it is a pleasant surprise to have you here today. Yeah. Yes.
Well, I'm an ordinary American like yourselves.
Oh.
And I'm here to urge you all to join Americans all across the country to demand that the government rebuild the police as a public safety agency. I'm going to share our organization's contact info in the chat, and I hope we can count on all of your support. Does anyone have any questions?
I do. So if someone comes up to you on the street and asks you for your money, who are you going to call? Ghostbusters?
Keeping people safe is what the police should be doing. Not punishing people who need help. And not coming in ready with guns to kill because the police have not been able to...
What if the bad guy have guns or might? How do I know?
That's why we need experts there to figure out the problem first. We need people who are trained to deal with all sorts of different kinds of social and security risks.
And what happens to you while they're figuring that out?
Granted, it could be an inconvenience, but better get it right than someone killed.
So they can get away with it.
The police will still find them. CCTVs are everywhere. It's impossible to get away with anything these days.
Unless they're wearing a mask. Am I right?
Excuse me?
I can't breathe. No more masks. Everyone, I can't breathe no more masks.
That's totally inappropriate.
No more
masks. Are you serious? That's not what it means. That's not what any of this means.
You and your support for the BLM coalition. That's breathing, liberty, and America. So what's BLM? Breathing, liberty, and America.
You guys should all get together and take each other out. Seriously.
Hey, where are you going?
Because you guys are nuts.
Hey, kid, come back.
Oh, what is that? Are you trying to infect me now?
Something for you.
Now what?
In news from the White House, President Tweet has doubled down on his support for what he thinks is happening in China. Yesterday, the president announced his support for Chinese President Xi's plan to, quote, build a great wall around all the Hmong people in China. Today, reporters explain, China had simply announced increased security against illegal drug traffickers. The president responded. Our presidential lip reader has transcribed the response.
A president has the right to defend himself against his own people. That's the one of the amendments, you know. Remember the Great China Wall of China? China knows walls. Not as good as mine, but still pretty good. Maybe someday they'll call mine the Great Wall of Donald Tweet. I'm not suggesting that, but some people are. Important people. Influential people. So we'll see.
Waiting for me? It's not time.
Hello.
How did you all find me?
Well, you posted your meeting today. So yeah, thank you for that.
Well, that serves me right.
No, don't run up.
Bye.
Masks up.
What?
Believed to be in response to the president's comments, similar graffiti appeared overnight at a Vietnamese pho restaurant, a Benihana steakhouse, and Su Shi's sushi boat. Police say they currently have too many suspects. Democratic and Republican spokesmen each blamed the other. For the Really, Really True News team.
Repeating the story from earlier.
You've got to be kidding.
I don't think so.
I don't think you...
Go away. No. I said no.
Nope. Oh, come on.
Thought no one would notice, huh? Welcome to the club. I can see you're confused. The club of Asian targets in America.
It's a misunderstanding. The president doesn't know what he was talking about.
It's just your turn. This plus the Hmong cop who stood by and watched while George Floyd was killed.
There were other cops there too. One of them was Chinese, I think.
Incorrect. Officer Kung was actually black. He was adopted.
Both black?
That's the American dream. My parents came to the US after the Vietnam War, and a lot of Americans already called us boat people. And so some Vietnamese tried fishing when we started doing better and buying our own boats. That's when our nets were sabotaged and our boats burned. But hey, blonde, white American lady came to the rescue. Her name, Tippi Hedren. She was a beautiful blonde actress. That's known for her appearance in Alfred Hitchcock movies, The Bird. In 1975, she came into Sacramento to one of the tent camps to help Vietnamese women there find jobs. And the women, well, they were admiring her beautiful painted nails. So she brought her personal manicurist to teach them the skills of the trade. Every time I drive by one of those new areas and I see a Vietnamese nail shops, well, I just get a warm feeling in my heart. Plus, I get a really good price.
I didn't know that.
From then on, we created our own jobs.
That's impressive. But it still sounds like a nice white lady saves the poor Asian story.
Not gonna lie, she helped. Now it's an $8 billion industry, and most of the workers are Vietnamese.
Oh, how much do the Vietnamese own of the industry?
Shut up. Vietnam's turn was after the war, the mid-70s to 80s. Ha! History quiz. When was the last time America went to Asia to join someone else's civil war? Question two. How did you know that Korea was going to be a total shit show? Because it was never technically a war. It was a police action.
Smooth.
Hello, ladies and germs. It's your favorite American in Korea, Hawkeye Pierce. Not to be confused with America's favorite Korean in America during the 1950s, who was? No one! Well, not literally, but not many. After the police action, immigration picked up with war brides and GI half Korean babies. And there was this problem. Americans were supposed to like South Koreans. But how do you know they're not North Koreans who we're supposed to hate? Way safer just to say no. Really, back then, my grandparents and all the Koreans in America were just grateful for one thing. At least they weren't Japanese. Come by.
When I got home from the war, the camps were nearly closed. I like to think that the whole nightmare collapsed from irony. The imprisonment of families of American soldiers who are fighting for freedom. But war really makes things better.
When I got back down to San Diego, right here in Encanto, there used to be a barber shop. I think the war had ended and I needed a haircut, so I went down, had a seat, and waited. People will come in, get their haircuts, but not me. Soon everyone had left and it was just the two of us. So, I say, how long do I have to wait for a haircut?
For you? You're not gonna get a haircut from me.
Why is that?
Your people killed my son.
The US Army didn't kill your son.
You're Japanese, ain't you?
Yeah. Well, I live right up the hill there.
Yeah, I know who you are. Your people killed my son.
No, I couldn't have. I just got back from overseas. I got a Purple Heart serving. Your son and I were friends.
Yeah, and then?
I'm sorry about your son.
You was in the U.S. Army?
Yes, sir.
You knew my son?
We went to school together. Right up there.
I don't know what to do. I lost my son.
I can't take his place, but I could get my haircut here all the time.
Come on.
He gave me a haircut. And when I asked, how much do I owe you?
You don't owe me nothing.
But I'd like to pay you something.
I acted too fast. Sorry.
From then on, that's the only place I ever went for a haircut.
I guess I'm overdue.
Mr. Ito, where are you hiding? It's time for your medicine. I mean, I think you only have a little bit today. I mean, ooh. Oh, hello. How are you?
Is that a Filipino accent? I can do that. Everybody loves Filipinos.
Everybody loves their Filipino nurse. Everybody hates their Filipino technical support person. Is anybody hiding from me?
I don't think I should speak for Mr. Ito.
Why? What did you hear?
I think he's Japanese American. He did his time.
You know, America has been scrambling to replace their original supply of cheap labor ever since they changed the law.
You're talking about?
Slaves. After the Spanish-American War, America claimed the Philippines and started the colonization thing, including recruiting Filipinos to the States as cheap, technically American labor. Right up until the Depression, when everyone was competing for not enough jobs. California had terrible riots against Filipino farm workers, and Congress passed a law. Every year, only 50 more. That's not enough girls to go around.
Welcome, welcome to another swell Saturday night at the Rizal Dance Hall. Gentlemen, allow me to introduce our lovely taxi dancers. Lucinda. Paloma. And Betty Sue. Remember the rules, a ticket for every dance, no rubbing, pinching, or squeezing, or I'll kick you out. Now pick your girl and give her a whirl.
Darling, miss me yet?
Since last night.
Darling, have you thought about what I asked you last night?
About going to Seattle, you mean? I don't know. I've never been.
Well, you've never been married either. This way.
Oh. I don't know, Eli. I love you and all, but it's all happening so fast.
It's the only way for us to be together, Mahal. Marrying you in California is illegal. It's not a felony in Washington State.
You want me to quit dancing for you?
Your job is bankrupting me. That dollar I make pulling asparagus every day? 10 minutes dancing with you, and it's all gone.
It's money well spent, isn't it?
It's the best 10 minutes of my week, sure. But what am I supposed to live on from Sunday morning to Friday night?
Love, darling. You gotta live on love.
Break it up, you two. No canoodling at the Rizal. You want the Purity League to shut us down again?
Well, what's the big harm? Those church ladies aren't going to come down to the stingery. At least the ball don't resolve that song.
Move along.
They sure would like to talk about the dance halls. I dragged them into Fitzgerald at the Kingsington. She and the other church ladies want to plan another protest. They're trying to keep us all out, you see. The Chinese, the Japanese, the Mexicans, and us. He bought World Fair next year.
Everybody rumba! Rumba at the resort!
You're a regular here, Fred Astaire, aren't you, huh? I imagine you teach those church ladies a thing or two about dancing.
I just drive their cars for them. But you, Betty Sue, you drive me crazy.
Buy me dinner after I get a walk.
Dinner's gonna cost 2 pizzas at some cafe. I only have enough for one more dance with you and chop suey afterwards.
Oh, how about you skip the last dance and save that dime for dessert?
How about I save you for dessert?
Anybody care to dance with me? I'm buying.
Mamie Savage! What are you doing here Saturday night? Should you be running your own dance hall instead of here messing with mine? Better not try to poke any of my dancers again.
Just checking out the competition. And don't worry, I've got my own dancers. Better. Prettier. Younger. Wander.
Oh, is that right? Is that right? Too bad they have to dance with drunks. We don't sell hoops like you do over there at the Velvet Cafe.
Get off your high horse, Tino. Now prohibition's over. You and I are selling the same thing. 10 cents for love and a minute-long dance.
You're wrong! The ladies would love us with or without the dance. We dress better, we dance better, and...
Tino! Call the doctor! Somebody shot Eli!
God almighty! Who whacked him? Is he dead?
No, he's not dead, but his arm's messed up.
How'd it happen?
We were just talking out on Market Street when this fella pulls up and yells, "You're a whore for loving a monkey!" Eli cusses him out and the guy pulls out a gun and pops him.
God damn. Okay, so why can't he just leave us alone?
Benny chased after him. I don't know.
I chased him, but I couldn't catch up. I brought Eli inside.
We need a doctor. His arm's bleeding bad.
Get a doctor to come down here to the stingery at midnight? It'll never happen.
Mamie, shut your trap. Nobody asked you. Everybody just calm down. Calm down. We're not going to call the cops. Just the kind of excuse they've been waiting for to shut us down. Vinny and I'll take care of Eli. In the meantime, everybody just keep dancing, keep dancing. Three dances for everyone. Geek off, strike up the band.
Hey, honey. What a little lead poison to get you down. It's an occupational hazard. Want my advice? Take their money and dance. But next time, save your love for one of our fellows. Fall for one of these guys. It's a kiss of death.
Your Royal Highness, your flowers have arrived. I apologize that I must deliver these myself, but that's clearly dictated in the terms of your imprisonment. That word, Paokalani? Is that the name of your plantation in Waikiki? The name of your flower garden? It must be extraordinary.
Haimalana aolena e o'i.
It is most certainly historical. I read that's where the police found the guns that were stockpiled for the revolution. Did they really dig them out of the ground? That's what we read in the newspaper. Without the newspaper, we would have no idea what is happening. Protesting, police are punishing the ones they catch, but that doesn't stop them. I suppose that's why it's the best that you're not allowed to read any of the newspaper. It's best not to know. No, sir. I mean, ma'am. Flowers and food. That's it.
The cause of Hawaiian independence is larger and dearer than the life of any man or woman connected with it.
Yeah. I don't think I should tell them that. But I'll see you tomorrow when the flowers come.
Mahalo nui loa. Aloha oe.
And you too, Your Highness. You too.
Is that a train? Who was the target before Hawaiians and Filipinos? Did they come on trains?
They came by boat from China.
Oh, I know this story. To build the railroads in 1869, right?
The first Chinese came for the gold rush. 49ers. Gamsana. Gold Mountain. They worked very hard saving money to send home. But when the gold got harder to find, the Chinese got robbed. And even killed.
What about the police?
There were only vigilantes and laws protecting only white men. That was the gold rush 171 years ago.
What about the railroad?
Yes. The Chinese were brought here to work hard, fast, and cheap.
Then after they finished the Transcontinental Railroad, they had all these Chinese men that they brought here trying to find work.
Hey, Congress didn't help. 1875, no Chinese women can enter. 1882, no Chinese men can enter. The ones already here, no money to go home. So they made their own.
We'll make our home in Chinatown. A place we can live and all belong. I'll plant my kumquat tree right into the ground.
With my own hands, and it will be strong, from quakes they'll stand. Two stories high, a window to look down, my little home in Chinatown.
And my home will be on my own land, where I can live in peace, look up and stand.
On our street there'll be some stores with treasures from home that you'll adore. Red silk and flowers can all be found near our little home in Chinatown.
A restaurant nearby, theater too. The shops will have bao, bok choy, duck stew. safe and sound. My little home in Chinatown. And my home will be on my own land, where I can live in peace, look up and stand.
I'll work really hard and make a plan, save every penny the best I can, and we'll see your dream rise from this ground. A little a song to sing. I didn't know what life would bring. I have a voice, I can make a sound, but only here in Chinatown.
So for Asians, it started with the gold rush. And when did it stop? Hey, you don't look Asian.
How long did you say you've been a target?
171 years.
You're close, but Mexico has been the target even longer.
No way.
Way. When we won our independence from Spain in 1821, the border argument started. Maybe we should have built a wall. Then in 1836, a bunch of you gringos decided to go to Mexico.
Hey, I'm not a gringo.
My man. Anyway, a bunch of you white wahoos in Mexico decided they didn't want to be Mexican or Americans. So they were going
to
be
Texicans. Welcome to Texas. No masks required. I'm king of the wild frontier.
The Mexican president, Santana, said, "You know you're not." And he stopped the revolutionarios at a little mission called San Antonio de Valero, which you may know as...
Remember the Alamo!
Some people never forget. So, us Mexicans have you Asians beat by 20 to 30 years, depending on how you count.
200 years? That's terrible.
Excuse me. You think white men have been targeting you for a long time, do you? The institution of slavery was written into the Virginia Slave Code, 1705.
300 and...
But the first slave cargo to America came in 1619.
That's messed up.
400 years.
Maybe even longer, with the Swedish and Dutch and... Everybody from Europe
Chinese
was
involved
in the slave trade.
The Chinese were brought here. 1821.
When he landed in 1492, Christopher Columbus wrote about the indigenous Taíno people he found there. They were very well built, with very handsome bodies. They do not carry arms or know them. They should be good servants. By his second visit, he required every Taíno man and woman, 14 or older, to bring him gold, or else 25 pounds of cotton.
Or what?
Or they would cut off the Taíno's hands and leave them to bleed to death. We fought back in 1,000 books, movies, and TV shows. As you probably noticed, it did not end well. Between disease and violence, 90% of Native Americans died since white people arrived. That's a pandemic.
That's actually genocide.
528 years.
One of the last violent battles between the federal government and Native Americans was at Wounded Knee.
The Federal War Department ordered the arrest of the dangerous Lakota war chief, Sitting Bull, a menace to America.
He was 60 years old now. His war party days were long past.
The treacherous warrior was secretly leading the Ghost Dancer Revolution to murder all the palefaces.
A wise elder and holy man, Sitting Bull knew what was and was not possible.
Approximately 50 officers were sent to arrest the wily red man.
Sitting Bull agreed to leave with the police. He stepped outside in handcuffs.
But Sitting Bull, who was not shackled, called his men to rescue him.
Sitting Bull's men called the tribe to rescue him.
There came a furious fusillade.
Hundreds of bullets were fired.
The cavalry arrived and two machine guns turned loose on the Indians' camp. Sitting Bull was shot 3 times. A police lieutenant claimed he had killed Sitting Bull.
To avoid the dishonor of being locked away by the white man, Sitting Bull's son, One Bull, shot his father.
He died at the scene.
Another son, White Bull, sang him songs as he passed away.
The killing saved many white lives.
The killing saved many Indian lives.
Fortunately, only 5 police were killed.
At least 18 Indians were killed.
During this brave action.
During this bungled arrest by the police.
I don't know what to say.
Say Black Lives Matter. Not because only Black Lives Matter, but because it's a place to start. It's not a surprise it's come to violence. The surprise is it didn't come sooner.
With flowers, please.